Hello, welcome to this lesson of our study of Enoch Calculus 1. Okay, so particularly in differentiability and continuity. Okay, so if you have not subscribed to the channel, kindly subscribe to support the channel as well. Okay, all right, so in this lesson, we'll just go through what we mean by differentiability. Okay, then after that, we'll do other videos on differentiating from the first principle. We take some special functions like polynomial functions, set functions, and trigonometric functions, differentiate them using the first principle. Okay, all right, so let's start with today's one. So differentiability, now we want to know if a function is differentiable at a point. Okay, so a function f of x is differentiable at a point A. Okay, so it is differentiable at a point. This is a point differentiation, that is what you are talking about. Okay, if this condition is exists, okay, if the limits of the fractional function f of x minus f of a as numerator divided by x minus a, the limit of that as s approaches a with this exists finally. Okay, so if it exists finitely, what this whole condition means is that the whole of this condition or the whole of this should exist. Okay, then it means the function is differentiable at that point A. Okay, all right, so let's take examples and search for its differentiability. Okay, so show that the function f of x equals x is differentiable everywhere. Okay, so now we said that for a function f of x, let me quote the condition here, for a function f of x to be differentiable at a point A, here we are trying to show that this function is actually differentiable everywhere. So for every point, the function f of x equals x is differentiable at that point. Okay, so for a function to be differentiable at a point A, we see the limit as s approaches A of f of x minus f of A over x minus A should exist. Okay, now f of x, for this question, f of x is equal to what? X. It means f of a for every point, okay, will be equal to a. So let's search for that limit. The limit as s approaches a of f of x is what? X minus f of a, which is a over x minus a. Now you see, we have x minus a at the numerator and x minus a at the denominator, so it means they will cancel out and we'll get limits as s approaches a of 1. Okay, and the limit of a constant, okay, in our limits, I didn't state it, but then limit of a constant means that the answer is just the constant, so it means it is equal to 1. So for every point A you pick for the function f of x equals x, okay, the limits, that is this condition, will always give you one, a constant. So it means it will exist. One is a value and the limit exists, meaning the function is actually differentiable at every point, because for every point you pick, you get a limit to be one. Okay, I hope this is okay. Now let's pick another example and see. Now you are supposed to show that f of x is differentiable in the domain 0, that is the open interval 0, comma infinity. So we are supposed to show that it is indeed differentiable within that domain. Okay, so to show this, from what we know, you have to find the limits as s approaches a, that is for a constant, of f of x minus f of a over x minus a. That is when you say that this is differentiable. So let's try to find the limit of this. So it means for f of x equals f of x equals square root of x, f of a will actually be equal to square root of a. All right, so this means that the limits as s approaches a of f of x is what? Square root of x minus f of a, which is square root of a over x minus a. Okay, so now with this, what we can do here is we can, to solve this limit, okay, actually I didn't solve examples on such limits, but before you can solve such limits, which includes what do you call it, square root. You need to do something, okay? But before you do that, you have to try to insert your x approaches a inside the function and see when I insert it inside this, okay? When I put x equals a inside this, I'll get square root of a minus, okay, square root of a over a minus a, which will give me 0 over 0. Okay, so you can use L'Hopital's rule here to solve this, but then I don't want to use L'Hopital's rule because you are not that strong in differentiation. Okay, that's what I assume that you don't have knowledge on differentiation. Okay, so what you can do here is that you try to rationalize the numerator. Okay, I have a video on set that talks about rationalization. Okay, so you have to know that you can also rationalize the numerator of a set. Okay, so we have limits as s approaches a of square root of x minus square root of a, okay, over x minus a. Now when I rationalize the numerator, what I have to do is just multiply both the denominator and numerator by the conjugate set, okay, of the numerator, since I'm rationalizing the numerator rather. Okay, sorry, a over square root of x plus square root of a. Now with this, when I multiply the two, you know, we have a difference of two squares for the top one because we have the same thing multiplying, but then the only operator that is separating them is plus and minus. Okay, so I have square root of x squared minus square root of a squared all over x minus a multiplying the square root of x plus the square root of a. Okay, so this will give me limit as s approaches a of x minus a, okay, to be the numerator, over x minus a multiplying the square root of x, okay, the square root of x plus square root of a. Okay, now with this, you know, x minus a can take x minus a out and we'll be left with limits, okay, limits as s approaches a of 1 over the whole expression square root of x plus square root of a. Okay, so now we can put our x equals a inside this, since this will give us a value. Okay, so this will give us 1 over the square root of a plus the square root of a. If you remember, in set you have two set adding, and then the values inside the square root sign are the same, just add the values in front of them. So there's one here, there's one here, so when I add them, I'll get 1 over 2 square root of a. Okay, and this is the value we've gotten. We don't know a, but let's go ahead and check for the domain open interval 0 comma infinity. For this open interval, it means that 0 is not part of the whole of them, and we don't know infinity, so we can't talk about infinity. You don't know the value actually there, so it means you start from 0.1. when you put 0.1 as a, the value will exist. Okay, since 0 is the only thing that will make this whole thing non-existent, and now 0 is not part, so it means that indeed this function is differentiable. The function f of x, okay, f of x equals square root of x, is differentiable within this domain. So every function has its own domain that it is differentiable within. Okay, all right, so let's link continuity and differentiability. One thing you should know is that differentiability, okay, when a function is differentiable at a point, let's say a, okay, the point a, then it is continuous, okay, continuous at that point. So it means when a function is differentiable at a point, it is necessary condition that the function is also continuous at a point. But when a function is continuous at a point, it doesn't guarantee differentiability. Okay, so it means that always when a function is differentiable at a point, it is continuous at that point, but the converse of that is not true, meaning continuity does not necessarily implies differentiability. Okay, But differentiability necessarily what implies continuity. I hope you get it clear. So differentiability means continuity at that point. But continuity may not necessarily be, or may not necessarily imply differentiability, okay? It can also imply differentiability though, but it's not a necessary condition for it. But differentiability is a necessary condition for continuity. Thank you, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, okay? All right, see you next time.